All right, here's a tutorial on one variable statistics on a TI83 plus or a similar calculator. So the calculator can do a lot of stuff. Maybe one of the first few things you learn are calculating these one variable statistics. This includes mean, median, standard deviation, to name a few. So to figure all these things out on a TI83 plus, you just have to go through these steps. First step is you have to enter your data. I have a separate video on entering data, so I'll pretty much skip that step. But basically what you do is you hit your stat button, then you hit enter, and it brings up your list. And in one of these lists, you type in your data. So note that I already have some data in here. Let's see, let's do our analysis on this third list here, where I have five observations. They're all about 30,000 or so. Let's figure out mean, median, standard deviation, etc., supposing these five observations were our data. So step one is enter the data. Step two is you want to hit the stat button. Let's see, what should I call this? Step two is run one variable statistics. And the way you do that is you first hit the stat button. So it doesn't matter if you're in another function like these lists here, just hit stat. It'll get out of there and enter what you need. And that'll pull up something like this. What you want to do is it defaults you over here to the edit menu, the edit column. We want to go over to the calc column. So let's say, maybe that shouldn't be a button. Go to calc column. So calc column is one to the right. I'll hit this right cursor here, and it moves me over here. And then what you want is one variable statistics. So you can just hit enter. And what will pop up will be one variable statistics. Don't hit enter again. You have to make sure that you tell your calculator where you put your data. Enter, and then maybe supply list name. So what I'm saying there is it will say one variable stats, but we have to tell it where our data is. The data we wanted to use was in list three. So if you look above the three key here, there's a little L3 in orange. So to get to the orange menu, you hit second and then three. So now we got one variable stats L3, and now I can hit enter again. And what will happen when you do that is you get a bunch of one variable statistics. I guess I can tell you what a bunch of these things mean. X bar is our sample mean. So what that's saying is if we added up all those five observations and divided by five, we'd get this number. Sigma X is the sum of your observations. Let's see. Maybe let's make this a checklist. Used in 243. This one is. I don't think you need that one. And you can also get the sum of X squared, sum of squares of observations. Not too important for 243. The next one, S of X, is the standard deviation. It's worth pointing out that this is our sample standard deviation. And you're definitely going to need that for 243. The next one, sigma sub X, is our population standard deviation. The differences between sample and population standard deviation, it's kind of subtle. For Math 243 purposes, the idea is we will never have population data. We're always going to have sample data. The idea is the whole purpose of statistics is to draw conclusions about the population based on the sample. If we had sample data, we wouldn't need statistics. We'd already have all our data to begin with. So we'll never know our population data, so there's no reason to try to compute the population standard deviation. So in 243, you'll never calculate the population standard deviation. N is number of observations. Kind of running low on room here. Sure, I guess you could use that in 243, although it's probably easier to count your observations than to ever do it this way. And then the next ones you got, if you scroll down, are min, Q1, median, Q3, and max. This is called a five-number summary. And it is the smallest observation, the 25th percentile, maybe first quartile is another way of saying that. I'm going to run out of room. There's got to be a better way to do this. Maybe I'll just say it rather than write it. Your five-number summary gives you the smallest observation, your first quartile, your median, your third quartile, and your largest observation. So that's what this is saying here. This was the smallest number I put in. This was the biggest. This was the median. And this is first and third quartile. And these will absolutely be used in Math 243. And that is everything you get out of one-variable statistics. You don't have to exit out of this list or anything. You can just start typing on your calculator. If you want to figure out what 25 times 3 was, you can just do it, and the calculator will keep working again. That is the end of this tutorial.